Let's talk a little bit about process or tools that you used. Since Migro was my favorite, I spent just a few minutes with it, figuring out just the chorus, and I was even gonna just like sing it into the camera because
do whatever you want, buddy.
I wanted to.
I've never heard it on guitar.
It seems like it was written on a guitar, frankly. I can't remember it.
We're from the chorus? You mean the B section?
Yeah.
You're playing the verse now.
And I'm sure I didn't.
So flattered.
I'm sure I didn't sing the melody correctly. But what I enjoy here is.
No, you really interpreted it.
I did.
That's beautiful.
Well, that's all I'm capable of. I'm not a sesh cat, man. I can't be anybody. I can only be me. That's a lot of jealousy.
Lucky you.
Oh, a lot of jealousy comes in there. Quite honestly, I cannot do session work. People never call me back. Because it's always this, like, that guy smelled like Willie. You know?
There's a chameleon component to me that I take great pride in. But you got to constantly keep it in check. Mm-hmm. Especially if you're too schooled, you can go overboard. Someone says, give me a loose, you know. We need some more Radiohead or Coldplay element, you know.
Yeah, I'm sorry.
Well, I use them as contemporary examples.
That you hear a lot.
Yeah, like if I'm on a keyboard session, somebody may say something like that. The artist or the producer. You can just flat out rip it off. If you know all the ingredients, mm-hmm. and you understand the ingredients and components that make that up, because you're really schooled in harmony and mechanics of music, like I am, mm-hmm. you can go overboard, and you constantly are at the risk of plagiarism. Mm-hmm. So it's a real fine art, again, a delicate walk of alluding to things or evoking the same vibe mm-hmm. out of respect, you know, with all the best intention, but making sure that the band still gets their take and twist on it. Mm-hmm.